Welcome back. Each year we all look forward to new artists coming to the fore in reggae.
In the first four decades, there were so many new stars each year, it was taken for granted that the music will always deliver fresh talent. For example, at the turn of the 1990s, acts like Buju Banton, Tony Rebel, Lady Saw, Garnet Silk, Caperton, General Degree, Matt Cobra, and Richie Stevens were all new artists. Since the start of the new millennium, however, the music has been hard-pressed to find new talent.
Step up in my town, making my arrival.
In 4 years, we have only seen six acts coming to the fore. This was about the same number who came in 1990 alone. The concern at this time is that the talent pool is on the verge of drying up totally. Last year saw for the first time in the music's history only one act coming to prominence. And some say he barely scraped through when he passed the acid test at Sting.
His parents named him Adija Palmer, up to the time he's known in the dancehall as Vibes Cartel. Vibes, welcome.
Definitely up to the time.
Yeah, man.
A pleasure, you know?
Yes, yes, yes. All right, how do you feel about the fact that you were the only artist to emerge in 2002?
Nice. Well, Mr. Williams, it's a very responsible feeling that, you know, knowing that right now Jamaica people, really, the attention span of a regular Jamaican right now is towards dancehall music. Due to its currency, you know what I mean? It's very short. So right now, for no one said the people really put Vibes Cartel as the hottest new thing on the market. It's a responsible feeling, as a feeling that make me have to try work harder to maintain.
Yes.
This level or even go higher, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So the feeling right now, that's a responsible feeling still, for real.
All right, so last year you started, things start happening for you.
Yeah.
You start feel a buzz in the market, and then you, some believe that Sting is where you were tested.
Yeah, definitely.
Do you agree with that?
Yeah, definitely. Most definitely. And for Sting, for me right now, and the international scene is a very good marker. You know what I mean? Because most places I've been internationally, people always tell me that the Sting cassette is the first cassette that really saw Cartel. And, you know what I mean? Regardless of Cartel being around in Jamaica for quite a while, you know what I mean?
Before?
Yeah, but the Sting cassette, most people that I do foreign shows abroad, they always say, yeah, the Sting cassette, the full suit of white, the whole vibe and energy, you know what I mean?
Okay.
So Sting definitely was a great help.
So, yeah. And those who say that Sting is like the university of dancehall.
Definitely.
You have to get graduated from Sting.
Definitely.
Before you can be truly accepted.
Yeah, because Sting really determine an artist's future for the following year, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because Sting right now is like the ultimate dancehall festival. So, you know what I mean? A dear, so you prove yourself worthy towards the new year, you know what I mean?
Because yeah. The fans at Sting are the people who define dancehall in Jamaica.
Yeah, the real grassroots people.
Yeah, they are the biggest consumers of the music.
Definitely.
They're the ones who determine whether a lyric is good or not good.
Yeah.
All right, bring us up to speed then, Vibes, with the career. Where are you now exactly? What have you achieved since?
Well, right now, Vibes Cartel, in certain really Jamaican populated place like New York, Miami, London, Vibes Cartel name is like a household name, you know what I mean? Like Elephant Man or Bounty Killer. Right now the album is coming up and we recently did two collaborations.
Yes.
One with Jay-Z and Pharrell, the Front End Remix, and one with Juice Santana and the Diplomats. Both of them, me and Wayne Marshall, you know what I mean? So on the album, crazy collaboration, we have two new videos out and we are doing a crazy foreign shows. We have a tour coming up with Bounty Killer. With the headliner, you know what I mean? In late October through to November. So that's music.
And how are the local charts? How are they treating you?
Well, I don't really read the charts.
Mm-hmm.
Truthfully speaking, I don't read the charts, you know what I mean? I just put out music and I just listen to the radio. But like charts wise, I don't really go after the charts.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely.
You use the people in life.
Yeah. Not saying that the charts aren't a valuable representation of what is going on in the dancehall, you know what I mean? Because you have very reputable charts run by some good people, but I don't really, personally, I don't read charts.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, the live responses that you get, and by the way, we must say to you that we think that the show just the other day, Heineken Heat Wave was where you really crack in now. I'm sure that Vibes Cartel is really here to stay and ready for the big time. This is how we feel, and I don't know, this is how we feel about that. We thought that that was the first time we really saw a different level. We've seen him on a number of occasions, but that particular performance, we thought, was a notch above the others.
Definitely.
Would you agree with that?
So yeah, definitely, because 50 Cent, you know what I mean, the artist rapper right now, I'm arguably the artist right now in the Western world. So, you know, say 50 Cent in Jamaica with the Alliance, the people come out with an open mind, they come out to listen. Yes. You know what I mean? And they have already been used to the Cartel performances coming up in recent months, so I had to come with something different.
Okay.
Even the intro song, you know what I mean? Carl Canai Part 2, I never used that song as an entry song before, you know what I mean? So it was crazy new stuff. And I love how the people responded to it and accepted it, you know what I mean? All much right. love to the people, straight.
Okay, you say, and I'm quoting you now.
Yeah.
My message is raw, mucky.
Yeah.
Dirty, greasy, grimy, and I want people to see and feel it.
Yeah.
What exactly do you mean by that?
Well, definitely, it's a Vibes Cartel now. We're born in Kingston and we grew up in Portmore, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So we just bring and break music and all is expression, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Art is expression, an expression of one's life and one's, you know what I mean, experiences. So that is what I'm bringing to the world, you know what I mean? And I just want them to embrace it because we're bringing it not just raw, unedited, like a speech. It's being delivered musically, you know what I mean? Witty, you know what I mean? Lyrically, melodically, you know what I mean? So.
But those weren't the words you used, man.
Yeah, so that's
why. You say mucky.
That's why, you know, when they listen to the lyrics, because, you know, some songs that Vibes Cartel came to prominence with on the underground scene, the people know.
Yes.
Like Gun Clown and Ifa Di Ja Sinan. See, you know what I mean? The people know what Vibes Cartel is all about, you know what I mean?
So it's just music.
Definitely, because music is entertainment.
It's that and that's all.
Yeah, I never.
You wouldn't subscribe to the argument that it contribute to crime. And
no, I would never do that because if I never heard that Sylvester Stallone or Arnold Schwarzenegger robbed any place yet, but I always see them in movies firing shots.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So movies is art, acting is art, and music is art, and art is a representation of life and a reflection of life. You can't make life be a representation of art. You know what I mean? So right now, we as artists, we just express what we see around us, experiences, first and second hand.
Yes.
You know what I mean? So you hear somebody expressing a song, that doesn't mean that he is the person who had the first hand experience of it.
But
that.
If the art and the artist have the power,
which we don't, but
to influence behavior,
wouldn't
you feel that you have a responsibility?
Well, artists having the power over people's behavioral pattern, I wouldn't see that more special than any other medium of trying to empower the people, because I never see nobody voting for an artist.
Mm-hmm.
I see them vote for politicians. That means politics have a great influence on the people too. You know what I mean? So I wouldn't say music, you know what I mean? And when Bob Marley said One Love, One Heart in 1980, the most people died in Jamaica. So music really is not, has no influence on crime. You know what I mean? As far as I see it.
Okay.
I don't know if I'm wrong, but that's just my opinion.
All right, sir. Stay with us right here. When we come back, we want to talk a little more. We want to find out some more about the roots of this artist who speak to lyrics that are dirtily, muckily, and all the rest. Vibes Cartel, right here on stage.
Timeless.
Welcome back. Our very, very special guest at this time is no other than the newest and fastest rising star in the dance hall. They called him Vibes Cartel. Or is it you, Vibes, who called yourself that?
Yeah, definitely. Well, that name now, originally it was three of us in a group, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And at the time, people were naming themselves like Cruz.
Okay.
So we just wanted to be different. So we just seek out a name that was different, but it had the same meaning.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Cartel mean a group of persons who really come together to control competition, you know what I mean? Control prices and limit competition, and that's what we were doing in Portmore as a crew. So, you know what I mean? The Vibes Cartel really came about from watching a cartel movie, and we just liked the name, and it just, we just used it.
All right, and speaking of crew, you're part of the Alliance, the Bounty Killer Founded Alliance.
Yeah.
Talk to us about that. What does it mean to you?
Well, Alliance, well, first, the Alliance, the name Alliance would mean a group of people or a group of friends. But since we're all artists, it's like super friends, you know what I mean? But Alliance is nothing but good, you know what I mean? Regardless of what people are saying in the streets. Not really people, just some really bad mind elements within the system, you know what I mean? Saying that the Alliance is fighting artists.
Okay.
Alliance cannot fight artists because Jamaican people from the gear listening here and they're worthy enough for them to give you the ratings. They're going to get the ratings. Because Sizzla is not in the Alliance and Sizzla is hot. You know what I mean? Crazy artists are not in the Alliance and they're hot. So the Alliance has no bearing on an artist's talent or artist's future. He has that bearing on himself. You know what I mean? So Alliance is just a group of friends. And the name does stick, and you know what I mean? People kind of get the wrong impression.
All right, let's talk a little bit about your roots now. You're a son of Portmore, right?
Definitely.
All right.
Sunshine community, you know what I mean?
Talk to us about the family that you came in or you're part of.
Yeah, my immediate family, I don't know, grew up with both parents, you know what I mean?
Yes.
Stable family environment, both parents, four sisters, one brother, you know what I mean? Normally go to school, Waterford Primary School, Calabar High School. You know what I mean? Get expelled from Calabar, where finish education at Tutorial College, where the kids, them and the fans of Cartel Finosa right now, education are the key, as we've always been hearing. But anyway, we grew up in Waterford, you know what I mean?
All right, why were you expelled from
Calabar? No, well, it's just attendance and really behavioral pattern. It's not really like academically speaking, you know what I mean?
Because behavior?
Yeah.
You used to get trouble?
Not really trouble, you know, we're a person who question everything still, you know what I mean?
Okay. So you were asking too many questions?
Yeah, we just have...
Unjustified questions?
No, not unjustified, but maybe the manner or the delivery of the question, you know what I mean?
Okay, alright.
Straight, but an attendance still, because Cartel always I go through there from high school days, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Going through there, you know, with school uniform and thing, but just hanging around, because we wasn't really paid much attention.
Yes.
At that time, but just catching a vibe and looking at the other artists. Even the said Bounty Killer from them time, you see me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and just know, say, yeah, Bounty Killer that and Harry Tadler that and, you know what I mean? Artists that were hot at the time, you were a power man that
so you couldn't resist the music even then?
No, because music was in my family. My uncles were DJs. They never really made it, but from growing up, they were always DJing around sound systems and I was always there watching.
Yes.
Yeah, so it's just...
Totally fascinated.
Involved, you know what I mean? So yes. It was just... my calling.
So you knew then that you were going to be a big star?
Most definitely. That's what everybody says in their mind, but I was saying that, but I was really working towards it at the same time. And knowing that I was a musician from even before I started even writing.
And you started at 10?
Yeah, professional, not semi-professional, like going out and penny concerts, local community stage shows, you know what I mean? Yeah.
But you really
and
didn't get the,
thing and,
the
you know
all
I mean?
Important bus.
Yeah.
Until just last year.
Yeah, definitely.
In your 20s, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Late. Yeah.
What kept
mid.
You, what kept the focus, Vibes? What kept the focus? Why were you confident that you will eventually make it?
Well, just comparing my lyrics to the lyrics of artists that were the hottest artists at the time, you know what I mean?
Yes.
And just knowing that, yo, my lyrics is on par or even better. You know what I mean? So, and we completely the motivation that, I don't know if it's motivation, but it's just like to prove a point because growing up, my father never really wanted me to really take up this DJ thing because it was like an eyeglass thing too. You know what I mean? He wanted me to more be like a 9-to-5 person. So it was kind of like I had something to prove, which gave me that extra drive.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Did you change course in your style, your delivery?
Well, my style and delivery, because I grew up listening to a lot of music, as I said, my family love music, so my style and delivery that I have now, I had that style from way back, like from about 97.
Okay.
You know what I mean? In Portmore. A lot of styles that I'm using, I have these styles from a long time, mixed back with some new flavor. You know what I mean? So my style has just been different from day one.
in the company, no, me in the two city club. The shoes not cheap like city parts. They put me Valentino summer shots. Must see no more to serve in the heart. The glass fast, see if it don't mark. Me be got them and bring me to your pass. Who that told you there? They mark me in the guards. Back up through that them call the arts. And they make it recommendation and demand. Don't say me ugly like former sparks. Don't say me like the best them from my class.
All right, talk to me a little bit about the college. What's the name of the college you went to?
It was a high school, but it was private high school, Tutorial College. That was after I got expelled from Calabar.
So what did you achieve there?
Well, I just got three subjects in our history, geography, and English, because I did arts at school at Calabar, which involved mostly writing and reading, like literature, English, geography. So, you know what I mean? That's where I really learned the art and the skill of writing at school. That's why I stressed that education.
Yes.
Regardless, you know what I mean, in all my interviews, yeah, and I
you're
stress the fact that, yeah, and I stress the fact that music is art.
So you're telling the kids
and
though,
art should not
lead the light.
Yeah.
Not to get expelled.
Yeah, definitely. It's not a good road, you know what I mean? But because it's not everybody have a lucky like Vybz Kartel. Mm-hmm. You see what I say? If you make it. And you know that to call crazy. You don't see the crime rate in Jamaica, and most people who are dead now are just between 17 and 25, you know. So you them have to really focus and know what they want in a life.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
All right, Vybz, just bring us to that moment when you got the all-important attention. Where? Who?
Well, it was a series of events, you know, yes. Because I remember, like, about 2000, I was driving with my manager, my present manager, now Ron Butler, and I was DJing a song called Cartel Rule the World. Mm-hmm. And as we reached the mall, he said, yo, I'm bound to kill off a DJ that you in there. I was like, yo, you know what I mean? But through the ratings, we were off for bound to kill and thing. We drive, got to the studio, we did the demo, and Butler introduced me to Bounty, and he took the CD, and the next day he was like, yo, you with your body in a rare. And from that, you know what I mean? It's like an overnight change completely. Okay. Real overnight, I forced me a seat. So that's why I'm going to say, no business like show business still, you see me?
So Killer took you to and expose you?
Definitely. I was doing foreign shows long before 2002, just by knowing Bounty Killer.
Yes.
Yeah, I was doing.
He called you on to do a little
Definitely.
Piece.
He hadn't even had to call me, and just by being associated with the man, got me a lot of recognition from producers, promoters, and because I had done been doing the underground work, you know what I mean? Everything just culminated into one, you know what I mean? Explosion, which was the collaboration with me and Wayne Marshall.
All right, and you're signed now, Vybz, to Greensleeve Records in London, as opposed to VP in the US. Why?
Well, VP to me, I don't like the operation, the mode of operation at VP. VP got too much artists to concentrate on right now. You know what I mean?
So it was your choice?
Yeah, because Cartel needs special attention. You know what I mean? Yeah, so I'd like any other person. So Greensleeve right now, I'd say I'm the only artist. You know what I mean? Me, you are 21, but you know what I mean? Two artists at a big major label, they can find time. You know what I mean?
So you went and searched the scene, Vybz and
I got offers from both labels.
Yes.
And we just opted to take the Greensleeve contract.
Could you tell us a little about the contract?
Well, the contract is just a 3-album contract. You know what I mean?
Over what time?
No, it has no time. It's just 3 albums. Okay. If I can give them 3 albums in one day, the contract is up.
So it's not like one a year for the next 3 years?
No. Actually, we want to start working on the album now for a March release.
Okay.
Yeah, because we ain't easing up.
So it's all good. But at the moment, dancehall is happening in the States, and the VP signed artists are happening.
Yeah,
Something might go on for them.
Yeah.
Wouldn't you say that?
Definitely. But you know, you're the first time for everything.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
So you see Sleeve able to do and push you the same way like that?
Definitely, because they have the clout, they have the same recognition as VP, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, and they have their market.
Okay.
Because the European market is a big, very viable commercial market, just like the American market. Only thing, the American market gets more attention from Jamaica because of the media,
absolutely,
the electronic media and the print media, but the markets are just the same.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's the work. And I have been doing a lot of work in America by myself without the help of any label, American label. Yeah.
So you're all poised right now, Vybz Kartel, to take it to the highest level.
Yeah.
An artist, a DJ.
A DJ, yeah, definitely. Straight.
Well, my friend, you sound the part. We have to say enough respect. But talk to us quickly before you go about your own family. You made a family yet?
We have a son.
What do you have to tell them girls out there about your life?
Tell the girls, tell them about my life?
Yes.
Well, them know my life, you know, because them seek me out and know everything about me, you know. If them can't get me, them just get butt line up.
Okay.
So, so just want to know them a friend of mine. You see me, I say? Yeah. Them say president or singer bigger.
Yeah.
AKA don't play. But me have my baby mother still and my son, you know what I mean? As the song suggests, Carl Kana, in a July, the pressure upon the we apply, and in a April, baby, I cry. So my son born April, you know what I mean? Jaim, straight.
Vice Carter, nice chat, sir.
Up to the
we
time.
We see you twice, and we're looking straight forward to the big times for
straight
you.
Up to the time.
And how you'll deal with it when it comes.
Definitely.
And this is definitely the time, if there was ever a time, when dancehall artists should rise up, wouldn't you say?
Yes, I would.
Because the world is calling, eh?
Yeah, and it's calling for the raw dancehall music, not like one time when we had to cross over on hip-hop beats.
Yes.
It's calling for the raw dancehall music, and that's great, you know what I mean? So that means the music that is created in the backyard, down a water ford around a water house, and that are the music the people want in New York City and in London, in Europe, in Belgium, Sweden, Belgrade, you know what I mean? So I just... You see me, I say?
Vice Cartel right here on stage. There you have it. A man who is very, very poised, very focused, as you can see, and ready lyrically and every Cali for the big times.
It's because we smoke the Cali.
Music.